as we said, these retroviruses have a capsid, which is an important part of their structure. And we focused on this structure for this particular work that we're publishing now. The major finding is the fact that we've been able to see, to observe at high resolution, images of this capsid with no modifications, in their natural way, no engineering. This is a breakthrough because this has allowed us to observe features, behaviors of this capsid that had never been observed before. And in particular, these observations allowed us to better understand the way that this capsid assembles itself, self-assembles. And we have seen how these particles, or these units, these building units, are plastic. They're flexible, much more flexible than what people thought before. The fact that we've been able to see these at high resolution is because we've been using a particular technique or experimental approach, which is the use of X-ray diffraction using crystallized material. So these are crystal samples of the capsid observed with X-ray diffraction. I want to raise a couple of points to finish this this talk about the work we achieved. Actually, we're very happy about achieving this, but this is not an individual or sort of a lucky outcome. It's a lot of work. And essentially, what I want to raise here is the fact that it's teamwork. So this is essentially two laboratories that have worked together, but not only these two, actually the whole Institute has been there for many years, over the years. So it's sort of a final achievement because of all this contribution. And it's not an exception in the country. Actually, what happens is that science needs a persistent effort and support, and we, of course, still need this to build local capacities, to build a scientific culture that allows, at last, to get these kind of fruits or end or final fruits of the effort. So we really want to acknowledge all these contributions from the Institute and the Uruguayan scientific community. The other point, of course, is a purely scientific one, is the fact that these kind of findings actually open new things. So maybe the most exciting part of it is what it is to come, and not just, this is just the beginning of something. So what I'm telling here is that, of course, one part of this future, these future ways, is about applications. Of course, by knowing better about the structure of viruses, we can, maybe not we as ourselves, but many other labs in the world as well, can pick up this information and actually use it to generate new drugs, for instance, new drugs that will somehow affect the assembly or disassembly of retroviruses and then become anti-retroviral drugs. Since these retroviruses have many common features, some of the things that we have learned with BLV, with this bovine leukemia virus, can be extrapolated to other ones, including HIV. I'm not saying, of course, that we have any kind of cure immediately, because this is very delicate for many people suffering. But it is kind of a contribution to open up new ways to novel drugs. So the fact of being able to dig really deep into the problem and understand new things at the molecular level is something that we're really happy to contribute to.